Well, we're moving to the QA session. We'll try to talk about something about PT, and well, let's keep going.
Okay, let's head on over here and do some Q&A. All right, well, Mr. Kojima, you are here with the fans, and these guys submitted questions on Facebook and Twitter to me and to Konami over the past week, so we're going to ask you some of those questions and get inside your mind, and we'll talk about that PT thing soon. There's always a twist when it comes to Mr. Kojima. All right, first question that came from the internet. If you could remake any game you've worked on so far using the Fox Engine tech, which one would it be?
フォックスエンジンで僕以外のスタッフがリメイクするんであればやっぱり MGS1が一番いいと思います。
Personally, I'm not too fond of remakes. I don't want to go and remake something old, but if it was as a producer and having some of my staff members going back to the remaking game, I would have to go with Metal Gear Solid 1.
Like MGS1 remake?
<笑>普通のリメイクじゃなくてもあれも16年ぐらい前のゲームなんで、サルの惑星が今新しいライジングってやってますけど、ああいう感じで、ちょっと違うリメイクというか、昔のいいところ取りの現代風にアレンジしたものがいいかなと思います。
And if I was going to, and if it was going to be a remake, of course I wouldn't want to make a standard remake, but you know, something similar to what Planet of the Apes is doing, taking the best from the past and do it in a very modern style and bring something brand new in that fashion.
Awesome. All right. Good answer. Next question that came from online is, what was your inspiration coming up with the character of Skullface?
Skullface はファントムペインの一番の敵役なんですけど、彼はその背景としては、悪ではあるんですけども、自分の言葉も顔も奪われた、そういう設定、だから骸骨の顔をしているっていう、そういうキャラです。
So, Skullface is the bad guy in the Phantom Pain, but it's not just a plain bad guy. You got to consider he's a guy that got stripped out his face of his native language, so that's why he has a skull instead of a face.
で、一方でそのスカルフェイスに仲間を奪われて、基地を奪われたスネークは、 復讐の鬼と化して、自ら肉をそげ落として、同じような骸骨になっていくという設定なので、スカルフェイスの影響でスネークたちもスカルになるっていう、そういうプロットになっています。
On the other hand, though, you have Snake that because of Skullface, he's trapped from his comrades, from his mother base, from his pretty much his home, he swears revenge, and in the quest for this revenge, his human side, his meat from his face, starts going away, becoming a skull in its own way. So plot-wise, it's kind of Snake himself becoming a skull because of Skullface.
もともとピースウォーカーのMSFっていうアイコンマークが骸骨だったんですけど、もともとスネークたちも骸骨のアイコンの舞台にいて、スカルフェイスに復讐するために自文たちも骸骨になって、最終的には骸骨がモチーフであるアウターヘブンを作るっていう、そういうちょっと悲しいストーリーの中で、スカルっていうのが非常に大きな意味を持つアイコンになっています。
Also, story-wise, some of you might, will remember that in Peace Walker, we had MSF, which logo was also a skull. So skull, Snake and his comrades were originally under the symbol of a skull. Then during the battle with Skullface, they started developing to Outer Haven, which is the logo itself is a skull. So it has that kind of sad story behind everything, all this. There's a subplot to this.
で、もう一つは、去年の E3 のメインビジュアルでレントゲン写真を使ったと思うんですけども、今回、民族、レースっていうのが、人との違いによる争いを描いてるんですけども、レントゲンを撮ると今の現代人っていうのは世界中のあらゆる人が同じスカルの形をしているっていうことも、象徴として使いたいので、スカルフェイスの、顔がないっていうのを、強調するためのキャラクターを作りました。
Also, another element, some of you might remember that last year at E3 we had some key art featuring Snake in X-rays. Now, one of the themes of Metal Gear Solid 5 is rays. There are differences between each race, skin-wise or face-wise or whatever it is, but actually current humanity as it is right now, if they're looked through x-rays, the skull, the bones are mostly the same for all people. So this is also one of the subplots, skull face, representing this skull, this faceless character being the bad guy. This is also one of the subplots that we have in Metal Gear Solid 5.
All right. Good and extensive answer. That fan will be happy. Next question is, what has been the most exciting Metal Gear for you to develop in your career? I remember the first time I was over with you was, I think, 2001 with MGS2. I was visiting you at the office, but you've done so many games over so many years. What's your favorite one?
毎回エキサイティングなんですけど、まあ、MGS の、メタルギアソリ、ごめんなさい、メタルギアの中でいうと、やっぱ最初の一番、メタルギアになります、メタルギアというゲームがあるんですけど、非常に反対されて、周りからも理解されず、それでも、まあ、形にできたっていうゲームなんで、あれがまあ僕の中で一番こう、印象深いタイトルになります。
I mean, every game has been fun, every game has been exciting to make, but if I was to choose between among Metal Gear, I would say probably the first Metal Gear that I worked on, a game called Metal Gear, because at that time I was new to the company, no one understood, no one grabbed the concept of what I was trying to create, and still somehow I got it done, so it was quite memorable for me making that game.
あとまあ、メタルギアじゃなければですね、まあ、携帯機ゲーム用に作った僕らの太陽という僕隊というのがあるんですけど、当時はそのゲームっていうのはカウチで家の中でしか遊ばせないという、まあ、そういう時代の中で携帯機に太陽センサーをつけて外の実際のリアルな太陽を使ってゲームをさせるというそういうゲームなんですけど、それもものすごい、まあ、内外のというか特にうちの、まあ、スタッフからの、まあ、反対とかがあったんですけど、それでもいいものができたんで、まあ、僕隊も僕の中では非常に大きなチャレンジでした。
And if I was to talk about non-Metal Gear games, it would be probably Boktai, a game I developed. The, at that time, and the concept of gaming was merely, you know, sitting on your couch, indoors, and well,I wanted to take advantage of this portable device and add a sunlight-sensitive device. So the game, in a way, forced you to play outdoors. It depended on sunlight. At that point, again, few people, especially internally, grabbed that concept. It was a rough battle. I had to convince a lot of people. Somehow, I made it done. I got it done. And in that regard, it was a very memorable game for me to work on.
Okay. Now, next question is a little out of left field. If you could play the lead actor in any movie, which movie would it be?
ですね、僕は喋りなんで、やっぱり無口なキャラクターがかっこいいと思うので、喋れないキャラクターがいいですね。ほとんど喋れないキャラクター。
Me, myself, I'm a very talkative guy, so I personally feel that guys that talk little or barely talk are really cool.You're awesome, so that's the kind of guy I'd like to be.
なんで、Mad Max 2のメル・ギブソンとか、そういうのに。
So probably I would go with Mad Max 2, Max, Max 2's Mel Gibson.
3じゃないですよ。サンダードームじゃなくて2の方ね。
But not the one from Mad Max 3, it's the one from Mad Max 2.
で、まあ、ほとんど Mad Max 2のメル・ギブソン喋らないんですよ。喋らなくてもキャラが立ってて、ドラマをこう引っ張っていくとい う, もう素晴らしい映画のキャラなんですけども、実はファントムペインのスネークも、まあ、マッドマックスにも近いんですけど、ほとんど喋らないですね。喋らずに、お話をどこまで引っ張れるかというのはもう今回のチャレンジなんで、そこもまあ重ねてみると、まあ、マッドマックスというのは僕の中では大きな存在です。
So, I mean, in Mel Gibson's character, in Mad Max 2, barely talks through the movie. He's a very, very silent character, barely has any lines. And still somehow with his personality, he pulls the story, he carries through the drama. So that is a very memorable part for me. As in Metal Gear Solid 5, Snake also has very few lines. His character barely speaks. So in a way, there I see kind of a resemblance. Somehow I see a...in the end, kind of a reflection of Snake and this character of Mel Gibson's Mad Max 2.
Do you see the new Mad Max trailer?
Yeah. 最高
Pretty awesome, right?
That was awesome.
もう10回以上見ました。
I've seen it at the very least 10 times.
もうね、僕あのゲームを作りたいんで。作らせてくれと。
I want to make that game.
ツイートしてるんですけど、誰も返事をくれない。
Let me make that game. I've been tweeting. I want to make that game, but no one has offered yet.
We'll put George Miller in touch with you. I'm sure he'd be interested. All right, next question is, how do you motivate yourself when you're feeling tired? The one thing that I always admire about you is your traveling around all these events, meeting with people, you're still making these games. It looks like you may have two games in development. We'll talk about that in a second. But how do you stay motivated?
やっぱりものづくり非常にエネルギー使いますし、まあそれだけだったらいいんですけど、やっぱりこういろんな交渉とかプロデュースもあって、ストレスが非常にたまります。
So I mean, again, creating something requires a lot of energy. And also, if it was someone that it wouldn't be that bad. But also, I step in as producer, so I have to negotiate. I have to talk with all people, which can become somewhat stressing.
本当は時間があれば旅行に行ったり、まあ、仕事を忘れてなんか遊んだりしたらいいんですよ。なかなかそういう時間取れないんで、何をしているかというと、まあ仕事終わって寝る前に、まあ、映画を一本見ると。
So ideally.What I would do would be travel or, you know, play something or just enjoy my time, but I don't always find the time to do that. So what I do is then after I'm done with work and before I sleep, I will watch at the very least one movie.
まあ、すごく感動する。
Every day?
Yes, yes.
Wow.
なるべくね。
For the most part, I tried.
ゲームズコムに来てる時は見れないんで、この4日間分ぐらいを日本に帰って1日に3本見ないといけないですけど。
I mean, for example, right now in Gamescom, I haven't been able to catch a movie, so when I fly back, I'll be watching 2-3 movies a day to catch up.
映画って、まあ、人が作ったものなんで同じように、クリエイターが戦ってるわけですよね、作品作り で、それが見えたりするんで、非常にこう勇気づけられたりしますし、純粋にその作品で感動したり泣いたり笑ったりできるっていうこともあるので、非常に短時間で自分を取り戻せるというか、疲れが吹っ飛ぶような、パワーをもらえるので、やっぱり映画っていうのは僕にとっては一番、効果的です。
I mean, in the end, movies are the same thing. They're created by someone. So in that regard, watching a movie gives me kind of a perspective of someone behind this, trying to create all this, trying to conceive all this. And this gives me, brings me back to myself, gives me a lot of hope and of ambition of what I can do. And also, of course, enjoying the movie itself, the joy, the sadness, whatever feelings the movie conveys to me. So in that regard, for me personally, a movie is something that in a short time span, it lets me come back to myself and remember what I want to do. So they are the most effective thing for me.
で、一番元気が出るのは映画本編じゃなくて、すごい苦労して作ったのにあまりうまくいかなかった映画のメイキングで、そのクリエイターが苦労して頑張ってる姿を見ることが一番こう元気になれる。
And also, the one thing that gives me most energy, the one thing that really energizes me is actually not even the movie itself, but for when I'm seeing the documentaries of making of a specific movie that or some movies that didn't go that well through development and didn't end up well, but you know, you see all the guys trying really hard to make this. That's the one thing that really energizes me the most.
Yeah.So you, how many hours of sleep do you get a night if you watch a movie every day? I'm just curious.
まあ4時間ぐらいですかね。
I'd say about 4 hours on average.
うちに、
Hard-working man.
すごい天才プログラマーがいるんですけど、フランス人の。ジュリアンっていう皆さんご存知だと思うんですけど。
I mean, for example, in our studio, we have one genius programmer, a French guy. Some of you might know him, Julian.
彼は、yeah.もうこの10年ぐらい計画的に4時間しか寝てないんですって。それでも頭はすごい回転早いし、健康であると僕にいつも言うんです。
So I mean, and always Julian Mercer, I'm sorry, he always comes to me and says, you know, for the past 10 years I've been only sleeping, scheduling only 4 hours of sleep and I'm healthy, and he's really fast thinking and he's so smart, so he always approaches me and tells me this.Yeah, I only sleep 4 hours a day. I'm so healthy. It's so good.
僕の方は、眠たいんですけど、一生懸命頑張って結果的に4時間しか寝ていない。
And on my hand,
これは大きな違いです。
And on my hand, there's a huge difference because I also only sleep 4 hours a day, but on my end, I'm barely trying and doing my best to stay awake with just 4 hours of sleep, trying so hard going day by day. So it's the same 4 hours, but it's fairly different perspective.
この間病院に行ってですね、その話をしたら、もうドクターから DVD を見るなと禁止をされましたけど見てます。
And actually, to be honest, I went to the doctor the other day and I was giving him the same talk, the same explanation of my daily routine, and he literally told me to stop watching DVDs. Of course, I pay little attention to that.
You ever fall asleep while you're watching the movie? It's not very good.
映画中に寝ます。映画中はなかなか寝ないですね。大丈夫ですね。会議中に寝てますから。
No, I barely fall asleep when I'm watching movies. I mostly fall asleep during meetings.
Fair enough. All right, next question from the internet is, what's your favorite part of MGS5 TPP? Is there one, I mean, you've been talking about this game now for a couple of years. Is there one aspect that you're particularly excited about?
これまでの MGS も、他のほとんどのゲームもそうだと思うんですけど、ゲームクリエイターがレールを引いて、そこにプレイヤーを誘導して、ゲームプレイヤーが仕掛けた遊びをこう提供するっていう、こう一方的な、インタラクティブなゲームの割には一方的なゲームが多かったんですけど、
So, so far games, what I've seen so far are pretty linear. I mean, they're an interactive medium, and despite that, the game designer traces a route for a player. The player follows that route that the game designer created, and you know, it's an interactive media, and doesn't seem that interactive.
TPP に関しては本当にそのマップを見て、どこにどういう経路で、いつ何時夜なのか昼なのか、どうやって潜入するかを自分で考えてそれを実行して。それを、ミッションをこうこなして最終的にどうやって逃げるかまでを考えるゲームなんで、そこが非常にこう本当の、スパイ情報映画を自分で演じてるみたいな、その自由度があるので、そこが僕が一番気に入っているところです。他のゲームもなかなかそこまででもないと思いますので、
In the Phantom Pain, the Phantom Pain is a game where the player has to see the map, decide how to go in, where to go in, when and how to execute the mission, with what is taking, and even plan the way out, how to get out of there. The player has to plan the whole thing. In a way, the player has to reenact what would be a spy movie in its own. So that's the kind of thing I wanted to do, and that's something that I haven't seen elsewhere, and that's something that I'm very excited about, The Phantom Pain.
Ground Zeroes って結構小さなオープンワールドだったと思うんですけど、Phantom Pain はものすごい広いとこなんで、例えば最初のカズを助けるミッションっていうのはもう結構かかるんですよ、時間が。それを根を詰めてというかこう、すごく緊張してやるので、1ミッションクリアするたびにすごい疲れるというので、そこは皆さん覚悟していただきたいと。こんなに疲れるゲームはないと思うんで、1ミッションやったらやっぱり半日ぐらい休憩しないと続けてはできないかもしれない。それぐらいの本格派というか、本当に潜入している感じを、与えてくれるゲームになっています。
So in Ground Zero, it was kind of a tutorial, so the open world was fairly limited intentionally. What the player could do was somehow delimited, soIt was clear to see what to do, but in the Phantom Pain, the first mission where you go and rescue Cass, it's a very stressing mission. I'm pretty sure people will have to put a lot of effort. It will take a lot of time. It will be a tiring game. You better be ready for that. One mission will require, after you do one mission, you probably need a half day rest or something. Just get ready for that.
Good response. Next question is, what advice would you give to an artist or designer who's looking to get into the games industry, and how did it all happen for you? I know, you know your background, obviously going to film, you know, researching movies and film school and stuff, but what's your advice to someone who wants to get into the business?
僕はですね、なんていうか、この仕事につけなかったらダメな男やったと思います。非常に幸運でした。自分の好きなものとか今まで吸収してきたものが全てこの仕事で、フィードバックできるので、偶然といえば偶然ですけど、映画を撮りたかったんですけど、映画撮れずにゲームデザインになって正解だったと思います。僕の場合は
Personally, myself, I was really lucky to be able to end up making games. If I wasn't making games, I probably would, you know, not be a memorable person at all. I was really lucky to find a job where I can do an output of all the inputs that I've had, of all the things that I've absorbed up to this point, up to that point, wherever I was in life, I was able to create something. I was really lucky in that regard. Personally, I was very fortunate to be in this situation.
まあ、なりたかったのはそのロス死刑の殺人家の警部ですけど、まあ、ならなくてよかったと思いますね。
I really want to make movies and also...If not, the one thing that I want to do was being a detective in the LAPD police department. I'm really glad I didn't get that job.
あのゲームって総合芸術みたいなところがあるので、まあ、映像のこととかお話のこととか、ゲームのこととかその人間工学のこととか心理学とかあらゆることを知ってた方が得なので、まあ、いろんなことを経験したり勉強したり、そういうブレインみたいなのを持っている人の方がいいと思います。
Game making in a way is a kind of a very, very global art, global concept where you have to know a lot of things, where it's human engineering, psychology, different arts. You have to put there are a lot of elements that you can combine and a lot of things that you have to experience and or study and go through. It's that kind of thing that you have to be able to know.
あとまあやっぱりあのすごくエネルギー使いますんで好きじゃないとできないと思いますねあの、ものすごく細かいところから広いものからその、ボリュームも含めて、時間の拘束もありますんでやっぱり好きじゃないと、ゲーム一本は作れないと思いますんで
And also it requires a lot of energy It requires a lot of energy so you really have toLike it, you really have to love creating things because it really requires a lot of energy. You have to think very detailedly and at the same time thinking very vastly, globally, and have a good brain to put all these elements from details to the macro, to put all this together. So you really want, have to like creating a game.
あとはですね、意外とチームで作ってますけど、新しいものを作ったりそれこそプロデュース業とかっていうのはそのスケジュールを守らないといけなかったりクオリティを守らないといけないといろいろあるんですけど意外とですね、孤独です、大人数で作っているようでいてゲームデザイナーっていうのは非常に孤独な、戦いを強いられます
And also one thing might be that most people will find this rather strange but it's actually a pretty lonely professionI mean, most people know that games are created in teams. We have development teams. Also, you know, as a producer, you have a budget to keep. You have a schedule to keep. So you're in contact with a lot of people. But still, it's quite a lonely battle. When you want to create something, people don't grasp it. Yeah, you have to go through it alone.
なので、まあ、やっぱり理解者、自分の理解者っていうのを、何人持ってるかっていうのが一番最後の力を発揮するところだと思いますので特に内側よりも外側にいる人の方が、まあ、理解してもらえると思いますあの僕にとってのジェフさんみたいなもので、そういう人が何人かいるかによって、まあ、戦い方が違ってくるとこれ結構重要なんで、そういう自分を理解してくれる人を、まあ、何人持ってるかっていうことですね
So because of this it becomes a huge force for youWhen you're able to have someone that understands you, and this doesn't need to be internally. In my experience, I found more of these people externally, people in my case, people like you that understand what I'm trying to do. In the end, this counts a lot. It gives you a lot of energy when it really matters to have someone that understands what you're trying to do.
Excellent. Well, yes, you inspire us too with the great work that you make. All right. Well, that's all the time we have for the internet questions.For you, Mr. Kojima, but I know there's some other things that we might want to talk about too.
そうですね。まあ、まあ楽しんでいただきましたというか、ありがとうございました。まあケルン5年ぶりなんで非常にまあ僕のテンションも上がってまして、またよければ来年再来年と来れたらいいなと思います。
Yeah, thanks for everyone in attendance. I mean, it's the first time in 5 years that I've been here in Cologne, and I'm pretty excited myself, and hopefully I'll see you next year and the year after next.
ちょっとまだあのビールとか、ね。
Keep coming back. We have so many games you're making.
ビールとかソーセージ食べ、まあ、あんまり食べてないんで。
Yes, because I haven't found the time to eat a lot of that beer, calcium, and the sausages, so I need to...
一つだけ言いたいんですけど、昔ライブ時の時に、僕ソーセージ好きなんですけど、ソーセージ好きって言うと次の日からみんな生のソーセージをいっぱい持ってきたんですけど、それはちょっと困りますんで持って帰れないんで、食べきれないんで。
And just one thing that I just remembered, when this event was taking place at Alepsitz, I said this in an interview that I really wanted to eat sausages, and the next day a lot of fans were really kind, bringing all this raw sausages which are impossible to go through customs, so please, I really appreciate that, butI cannot take that home, so please don't.
Very cool. Well, before we wrap things up, let's move on to something that was the talk of the internet over the past 24 hours. You were on stage yesterday at the Sony press conference, revealing some Metal Gear Solid 5 information. There was this mysterious teaser afterwards for PT, which at the time Sony had said was a new game from... a new studio. I think people downloaded that. There was a playable teaser, and those that played it were in for a bit of a surprise, I guess, because it seemed like at the end of that teaser, if you get through it and you play through it and you solve the puzzles, it seemed like it was revealed that you're working on a new Silent Hill game with Guillermo del Toro, starring Norman Reedus. Everyone was talking about that. So now, since this is the first time you're, I think, able to sort of speak about this, tell us, what is PT? What can you tell us about it?
まずその PT 遊ばれた方いますかね?
First off, in the audience, who played PT? It's curious.
Oh, 怖がりばっかりじゃん。
Oh, so everyone is scared to play it, too scared to play the game?
Or they're probably traveling at home with their PS4s.
Silent Hills のことはちょっと今の時点ではあまり、お話できないので、PT の話をしたいと。
So as of now, I cannot talk too much about Silent Hills yet. So I'd like to talk a little bit about PT.
PT っていうのはプレイアブルティザーの略ですね。
So first, PT stands for playable teaser.
で、あの、そうです、そうです。あの、深い意味はないです。
Yeah, that's the point. There's no deep meaning into it.
で、あの、まあ予告編とかティザームービーとかを流すんですけど、ゲームなんで、まあムービーじゃなくて本当にプレイアブルで、自分がインタラクティブに遊ぶことでその、タイトルとか IP にたどり着くようなものを作りたかったんで、それのまあ業界初の試みです。
So I mean, you see all these trailers, all these teasers, but it is a game, so I wanted to have something that was really interactive that you could play through. After playing it, through playing itclearing something, you would finally get to the IP or the title or whatever it was. That's what I wanted to create, and I believe that's an industry first. I wanted to be the first one.
まあ非常に怖いですね。So, 怖くて、で、まあその最後のパズルって非常に難解です。これわざとやってます。
So this is a very scary game, and the last puzzle is ridiculously difficult. This is completely intentional.
で、僕の予定では1週間ぐらい解くのにかかると思ってたんですけど、半日で解かれてしまいまして、やっぱり今のユーザーさんはすごいと思います。
I personally expected this to take at least a week to be solved, and I was really surprised it took less than half a day. So yeah, I underestimated the current fans, the current players.
モビーディックの時は、あの VGA の時は、あのその流した途中ぐらいからバレてたんで、それよりはマシですけど、
ね。I mean, it's an improvement because when we show Moby Dick during the BGAs, but half the announcement, halfway the announcement, people already had to figure out. So I guess we're getting better.
Sneakier.
昨日のまあ深夜に最初のイギリスの女の子を囲むツイッチの人々が解いたんですけど、あれがしてほしかったんですよ。世界中の人たちとツイッチとかでつながって、あの。まあ、いろんな言語を解析しないと解けないんですけど、世界中の人が、一つのゲームをよりどころにしてコミュニケーションとして集まってみんなで協力して成果にたどり着くっていう、そういうティザーゲームを作りたかったんで、そこは、成功したので非常に満足しています。
So I believe it was a girl in the UK last night that solved it out, andYou know, in a way, that's precisely what I wanted to happen, by which I mean I wanted people to get together, cooperate, you know, their cryptic messages in different languages. So I wanted people over internet or whatever to get together, trying to cooperate, trying to solve it, trying to figure out what else is. So this is precisely what happened. In this regard, I believe this was a success because I wanted to create something that required people from different countries, different parts of the world to cooperate to get solved.
何言おうとして忘れてしまった
まあ、
ね、で、
あ、写真と、
いやいやいやいや、
780
怖いんですけど、
あ、ペギー、
ノーノーノーノ
ー Maybe more coming. All right. Lights back up.
Lights back?
All right.
No.
Oh. Stop the video for a second.
Stop the video for a second, please.
Oh.
Watch out. The gap in the door. It's a separate reality.The only me is me. Are you sure the only you is you?
これ無料でダウンロードできますのでやってない方は遊んでくださいね。
So everyone can download it for free on PlayStation 4. So whoever hasn't played it, please go ahead and download it.
今は誰が作った、何の目的で作ったこと、ゲームなのか分かってしまったんで、まあそんなに怖くないと思います。
Now, it shouldn't be that scary because as of now, you already know who made this game, who's behind this game, what is this game. So it shouldn't be that scary.
これはそのフォックスエンジンとか僕らの名前を隠して、まあ、インディーズの、まあ、とあるグループが作った、わけのわからない謎のゲームとして、ダウンロードしていただいて目的も何もかもわからないその情報が全然ない中だからこそ怖いっていうそういうシチュエーションを狙ったものなんで、まあ、今やるとそんなに怖くないと思いますけどそれでもまあ怖いので一回試してみてください。
So one of the intentions behind this game, of course, we hit the Fox engine that we ourselves we were involved in this project. So people, when they downloaded it, they never heard of PT, they never heard of this development studio. The game in itself doesn't even give you a purpose, doesn't tell you what you have to do. So this in itself, we believe that gives fear to people, the fear of the lack of information, what is this? So, I mean...By now you all know this. Still, we believe you will get a scare of this game.
で、まあ、フォックスエンジンでサイレントヒルを作ったらどんだけ怖いかっていう、まあ、実験も兼ねてたんですけど、実はですね、これインディーズに見えないといけないんで、かなり手を抜いてます。
So, actually, this was an experiment of making a horror game with the Fox engine, but it had to look like an independent developer game, so we had to drop the quality.Intentionally, quite a bit.
すごい難しかったです。今まで一番難しかった。Fox エンジンでもっと綺麗に描けたり、もっと操作感とかも良くしたり、もっと驚かしたりできるんですけど、それ以上すると、まあ、プロが作ってるっていうのがバレてしまうんで、そこのさじ加減っていうのがなかなかできなくて、一番今までで難しかったですね。
That was the most difficult thing I've done this far because using the Fox engine we can do better graphics, better playability, but we want to lower that because if weraise the bar that high, people would know that it was a big studio behind it. So that was one of the most difficult things I've done so far.
で、本編のサイレントヒルズで一つだけ言えるのはですね、まあ、デルトロさんとも話してますけど、まあ、おしっこをちびるようなゲームにしようっていうんですけど、最近はまあうんこを漏らしてしまうようなゲームを作ろうと。 いうことで、取り組んでますんで期待してください。
The one thing I can tell about Silent Hills, this is something that I've been talking with Guillermo del Toro as well, but originally we were thinking of making a game that would make you pee your pants, but at this point we've changed our minds and we are aiming for a game that will make you shit your pants.
まあ、怖すぎるとゲームってやめてしまうんですよ。
But one thing that you have to keep in mind is that if a game is too scary, people just won't play it.
で、映画とかそのアトラクション、レールに乗り物に乗っていくやつは目をつぶってても出口に出るんですけど、ウォークスルーのゲームっていうのをやめてしまうんで、あんまり怖いゲームなかったと思いますけど、僕らはそれをやろうとしてるんで、まあ途中でやめてくれて結構ですと。まあ怖くて出なくてもいいんですけど、もうそれが人生で一番怖いような、うんこを漏らすような、うんこを漏らしてしまったようなゲームっていうのを目指してますんで、まあそこは、怖がりの人はちょっとできないかもしれませんけど、そこは期待してもらっていいところですね。
So the one thing in movies or in attractions, you know, it's about to start playing pressing the play button or just getting in the ride, and you know, if it gets too scary, just keep your eyes shut and somehow it'll be over. But if it's a game, people will just stop, you know, and won't keep on playing. So that's why there's a limit of how scary you can make a game.But in this case, we're totally ignoring that. And you know what? If you don't want to keep playing through the game, so be it. We don't care. That's the game we are aiming for. We're aiming for a game that will make you shit your pants. And so, yeah, that's...
パンツの替えは持ってください。
So please make sure you have some changes.
限定版にはパンツをつけるかもしれません。限定版には。
The limited edition will probably include a pair of trousers for everyone.
Collector's edition.
で、これ、PSN のところに行くと PT のこのビジュアル出てます。で、PT っていうのがあって下に 7780S スタジオっていうのがありますけど、これ何のことか分かりますか？この制作スタジオの名前。
So, this is the logo that you will see when you go to the game in PSN, the 7780 Studios. Any idea what 7780 means?
I don't know. Is it S for Silent Hill? Or, yeah, what's, yeah, I'm sure it has some significance. Like Moby Dick, what's the significance?
7780の S の S は Silent Hills の S です。
Correct. As you say, actually, the S in 7780s is the S for Silent Hills.
で、Silent Hill っていうのを日本語で言うと Silent は静か、Hill は丘なんで、静岡という日本ではサイレントヒルのことを静岡県っていう県エリアがあるんですけど、静岡と言われます。
So the thing is, when you say Silent Hill, when you translate directly to Japanese, it's Silent is Shizuka and Hill is Oka. Now there's a prefecture in Japan called Shizuoka, so gamers, it's kind of gamer slang in Japan to call Silent Hill Shizuoka.
で、まあ、7780っていうのを Google で入力すると、まあ、50番目か60番目か70番目ぐらいに静岡県の面積と出ます。
So if you Google 7780, somewhere in the results you'll get the 7780 square meters is actually the area for that prefecture, Shizuoka.
はい、それだけですけど。
That's the meaning behind the name.
ここからバレるかなと思ったんですけど、誰もまだ気がついてないらしい。
Yeah, we kind of were thinking that people might get the hint from here and figure that was something else, but well, no one caught on that hint.
So much detail though. So remember when you first talked to me about Moby Dick Studios, you had like a little drawing what the logo is going to be, like Norway and everything, and it's like, yeah, all thought out.
で、このビジュアル非常に良くない写真なんですけど、素人っぽい。
And as you can see, the picture is very amateurish, very low quality.
これはうちのスタッフの住んでる裏庭です。
This is the backyard of one of our staff members.
日本の。
So it's just a Japanese backyard.
ここからもバレるかなと思ったんですけど、バレなかった。
We thought someone also might catch him that is like typical Japanese backyard.
まあいろんなところにヒントは隠したんです
けど。So there are hints spread all over the game.
Wow.Well, it's, yeah, it was a cool way to announce a game, and I'm amazed that you're able to work on that and work on, obviously, Phantom Pain as well. So you're going to be very busy at Kojima Productions here over the next few years.
そうですね。まあ、まずは Phantom Pain 完成させて、まあ、まあ、並行ですけど、で、PT というか、Silent Hills ですね。
So, yeah, we have to get the Phantom Pain finalized, and on parallel, of course, we have to work on Silent Hills.
まあ、意外と僕も含め怖がりが多いんで PET のチェックもみんな怖がって嫌がってましたけど。
Yeah, the one problem that we have is that in our staff, in our team, we have a lot of people that are really, really scared. You know, they get scared easily, including it himself. So we had a lot of problems on who was gonna debug and test the game.
まあメタルファン TPP のチーム員にこれモニターでやってもらうんですよ。ヘッドホンで。
Yeah,
こんなブースまで作って。
So,
ビニールのテントみたいな中でやったんですけど、怖さを増すために。
So in the studio, actually, we had a small booth. It was like a small camp tent to play it, and we had team members from the Phantom Pain go into and just, you know, monitor the game, tell us how, what it feels like, and put the headphones in and get him in the tent.
で、大体怖がりの人はヘッドホンを半分外して、そのテントのチャックを開けて聞いてきますね。ここのグラフィックはおかしいんちゃうかとかいろいろ怖いから聞いてくるんで。
What most people did, this is typical behavior in people that get scared easily. They just put one headphone off, they open the tent, they're just like, hey, I think this graphic is incorrect, and they just start throwing questions, just like, that's when they're really scared.
まあでも怖がりの作るホラーっていうのが一番怖いので、ホラーヒチコク。
But as Hitchcock said, probably the scariest thing is made by people that get scared easily. So,
本当にまだされてない方は遊んでくださいね。
So everyone that out there, everyone here at least that hasn't tried there on Twitch, hasn't tried PT, please make sure to try.
怖いので、友達同士で集まってワイワイやったりとか、Twitch でみんなとこうネットでつながってやった方がいいと思いますね。
So it's a very scary game. So I mean.If you get scared easily, you know, just get together with your friends or whatever, or on Twitch with different people, and just go ahead and play it.
Lost the microphone. All right. Well, thank you so much, Mr. Kojima. It's been amazing to have you with us here, teasing, obviously, PT, Silent Hills, and lots of great Metal Gear stuff, I'm sure, still to be told. And we look forward to hearing more about Silent Hills, I'm sure, at other events coming up soon, with an S, right?Not Hill? Hills?
S
です。
S
です。S。楽しみが複数形です。
So,
怖さも複数形です。
It's in plural. Plural fun, plural scariness.
Plural scariness. Okay. That's something new. All right. Well, everyone, let's give another round of applause to Hideo Kojima for coming out and doing this whole event. Thank you, Mr. Kojima. And remember, you...